But the weather gonna come.
Watch out.
The rain is gonna come.
Uh-huh.
The snow is gonna come.
Yeah.
Fog is gonna come. And the same ant that was in a single file line has now got knocked off course. Lord have mercy. So now what the ant does is he turns his antennas toward the sun. Y'all hear what I just said? He turns his antennas toward the sun to find his way back home. And somebody here can testify that you were lost, but somebody loved you enough to bring you back to the book to get you back in line. Well, here it is, that little boy, who was in the grocery store. Police came up to him and asked him, said, little boy, I've been watching you. You will, for the last 30 minutes. So now I see tears are falling from your face. So little boy, explain to me what could possibly be going wrong in this grocery store. Said, well, Mr. Police Officer, I came into this grocery store with my mother. Some way, somehow, my mother has walked off and left me.
Yeah.
Police officer said, well, this is what we'll do. We'll go to the customer service. We will, ask the customer service agent to ring your mama over the overhead. Can I get a witness in here?
Yeah.
Or can you say amen? They called his mother not one time, not three times, but four times.
Yeah.
But the mama never responded. Can I get a witness in here?
Yeah.
Or can you say amen? So the police officer took the little boy outside in front of the store. And he said, little boy, I want you to just look around and tell me if you notice anything. Or is there anything that resembles your house? Can I get a witness in here? Or can you say amen?
Yeah.
So the little boy said, brother, police officer, if you just take me down this street and turn me to the right, there is a church with a steeple on top. Can I get a witness in here? Or can you say amen?
Yeah.
So the little boy said, if you can take me to the steeple, I can find my way home. And that's the good news through Providence. Just take me to the foot of the cross, and I can find my way home. If there anybody here, if there ain't too many, if there ain't too religious, you can lift up your hand and say, Father, I stretch my hands to thee. No other help I know. If thou withdraw thy hand from me, where shall I go? Is there anybody in the building? You can stand up on your feet and grab your neighbor by the hand. Shake that neighbor's hand with some power. Shake that neighbor's hand with some conviction. And look at that neighbor squat in the arm and say, neighbor, I was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see. And I've never seen a righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging for bread. Good day, children. May God bless you real good. But the good word is, at the cross, where I first saw the light, and the burdens of my heart rolled away, it was God by faith I received my sight. And now, I said, and now, this. Watch this. Watch this. This insect in chapter 30, verse 5, the writer says, he not strong. He's small, not strong. But you don't realize how strong he is until he bites you. And that bump swells and stings and burns. And now you go to the grocery store, to the convenience store, to CVS, Walmart, Walgreens, looking for Wintergreen alcohol. Sorbet Jr., Campbell, Vanique, I'll talk back to me again. Some good old women that mama got in her cupboard. You're looking for anything and everything to relieve you of the sting. And all Solomon is saying is that if you look at it long, if you watch it long enough, you will see just how genuine the ant is in her work. So everybody in here, you have work in you. Question is, will you do the work that's necessary? Because talk has always been cheap. Oh, you don't like that? Now, rewind, play. Talk has always been cheap. God has called me to work. And since he's taught me to work, I'm going to work while it is day. For when night comes, no man can work. So there are lessons from this end. And if we learn from them, we'll be wise. Because our life will be made easier by way of ministry. Not saying that the work won't be lighter. Sometimes the winds will blow and will cause you to question your own sanity. And when it happens, guess what? God is right there. And so you're bending, but you're not breaking. And the only thing that's causing you to bend and to sway versus break is the fact that God has called you. Sometimes that's the only thing you have to hang your hat on, is the fact that God has called you. Now watch this. Problems don't have to be, infiltrate the church. If every individual in the church know who they're working for. I'm working for the Lord. Now, if you're working for the Lord and I'm working for the Lord, we don't have a problem working together because both of us are kingdom-minded rather than kingdom-blinded. So everything I do, I look at Christ. So now, guess what we do when we come together to work? We pray together before we work. We learn as to what it will take for the relationship, this working relationship that we have. What will it take for it to be founded on love? So that it can be authentic and genuine. So that we can love without any hesitation, without any reservation. I love you not because I'm commanded to love you. I love you because it's in my heart. So now I can eat with you. I can embrace you. I don't have no motives. I can love on you and talk to you and pray with you because it's genuine. Every head is bowed and eyes closed. If you're in this building, we extend the invitations to the church. As doors of the church are never closed, they're always open. So if you're in here this morning and you have yet to make the most important decision of your life,